was no minimum wage. You was coming here on slave ships. That's morning. You're called Gully Wagon Coon. And the other day, they said, what? We're going to send all the Jamaicans home. Even though you built the NHS, even though you slaved and built this country, they said, you know what? Send them home, man. If they can't produce a passport, send them home. Black men, you're the ones that are mourning. The Bible said the real Jews are mourning. And the only people I see mourning is black people. You go to America, you see black people mourning. You go to Jamaica, you see black people mourning. You go to Brazil, you see black people mourning, man. All over the globe, it's certain called ghettos. And every ghetto over the world, all over the earth, is filled with black people, man.
Right.
Filled with black people. And the Bible said the real Jews are mourning. And so far, that sounded like you, black man. I'm going to read some more. But so far, it sounded like you, man. Maybe you are the real Jews. I'm reading a prophecy that will happen to the Jews. And so far, I've pointed out that nation that's mourning, man. Read, look more, read.
And the gates thereof languish.
And the Bible says our gates languish. They languish. You know what a gate is for? A gate is for protection, man. And we don't have that. We ain't got no protection, man. The police chop my dog, what happened? Nothing. Who spoke on our behalf? Who lost the job for the killing of Mark Duggan? Who got suspended for the killing of Mark Duggan? You know what, I'll help you out. Nobody did. Who went to prison for the death of Stephen Lawrence? Nobody did. Who went to prison for the New Class Massacre in 1981? Nobody did. You know why? Our gates languish, man. The so-called Jewish man, he has protection. The so-called Jewish man locked up Nazis that did old war crimes. Black man, who went to prison for locking up you? Who went to prison for putting you in slave ships? Who went to prison for making you swing a machete from sun up to sun down in Jamaica after cocaine? Black man, do you know this? In Jamaica, your job was to cut sugarcane all day. You know, black man, today's a beautiful day, ain't it? It's a nice, beautiful, sunny day, man. It's a beautiful day alive. And guess what? I'm going to tell you something. It was a nice, beautiful day like this that black man was forced to cocaine. It was a nice, sunny day like this that black man was forced to pick tobacco, man, with the hot sun on their back. The black man wasn't out there eating popsicles. He didn't have a nice glass of water. He was in the park. It was a nice hot day like this that black men were forced to pick tobacco, forced to pick cotton, forced to cocaine. And guess what? The next day, you know what the black man did? He cocaine again. And the next day, you know what he did? He cocaine again. And the next day, he cocaine again until he was old and died, man. That's what your people did to my people. And guess what? Nothing came out of it, man. We can't even get a public apology, man. But we done.
They are black!
What color are they?
Black!
What color are they?
Black!
And the Bible said the real Jews are black, man. So how is someone going to tell me color don't matter, man? When God put it in the Bible, if God put it in the Bible, it matters, man. So you tell me something. What else is in the Bible that don't matter? If color don't matter, even though God put it in the Bible, what else don't matter, man? Give me the book of Acts 30:31. Color is in the Bible, black man. And the reason why you don't know this is because your pastor ain't teaching you this, man. The pastor ain't teaching you this. If every black man woke up tomorrow and found out the real Jews are black, maybe we'll think twice before we sell drugs to each other, man. Maybe we'll think twice before we kill one of our brothers, man. Maybe we'll think twice for having sex with a black woman and throwing them away, man.